Hello, good morning students. I am Mansi, your SST teacher, and today I am going to tell you about the chapter 1 of Introducing History. So let us start this chapter. First of all, here we will study in this chapter about the human past, what the history and what is history and why do we study history, and about the sources of history and how do they help us study the past and how does geography influence the history. So first of all, the question arises here: what is history? But before this, we will discuss about the human past. Humans have different past, and we use the term most past in the plural because different groups of humans and different past life. Some were like the kings and administration, military men, while others, and some were kings and were farmers and merchants, craftspeople, artisans, hunters and herders. Now, each of them followed by the different customs, lifestyle and rituals. Okay. Next is, what is history? Here, the history is the study of the events and people and their way of life in the past. So, that's why it tells us about the past settlement, economy and society. And it also tells us about the clothes, people, war and their food habits, their occupations and the study of the past also helps us to understand and belief and faith. So from the life of the hunter-gatherer, one who either hunted animals or gathered food, the early humans began cultivating land and then slowly moved towards a modern lifestyle. So that's why this is the history, okay? And this history is divided into three steps. That is the division of the most common division of history we will discuss here. Division of history means the history is divided into three parts, like prehistory, protohistory and history. Prehistory is the period for which there are no written records. We have no any written records and we rely entirely on archaeology to know about the lives and the history of the people and living during this period. And archaeologists explore, excavate and study the remains to understand the history of prehistoric people and civilization. Okay, next is the protohistory. If I am talking about here protohistory, then protohistory is the period for which we find some written records, but they are the few or yet to be deciphered. And for example, the Indus Valley civilization means in protohistory there is the period for which we find the some written records, and but they are the few or yet to be deciphered. Okay, so that's why next is the history. History is the period for which we are able to decipher the written records for past event, means we have lots of past events record and able to written records of the past events, and many of these records are found on rocks, clays and bars on the bridge. Then they provide the important information regarding this period. Next is the sources of history. Here the sources of history is very important part of the human's past, because history is studied on the basis of the records of the past events, and these records are known as the sources of history. And the scholars who study the past using the various sources are called the historians, and they explore the clues and material left and behind by the people in the past. And the sources of a period can include like the fossils, monuments and bones, remains of the settlements and utensils and the pottery tools and implements, literature, written record, painting, inscriptions, edicts and coins. And one more thing is that we can divide the sources of history into two groups. First is the archaeological and second is the literary. Okay, so archaeological sources include the fossils, remains, the artifacts and tools and implements, and edicts and inscriptions, monuments, coins and so on. They are using the lots of coins and inscriptions, edicts and also. And the scholars who explore these sources of the past is called archaeologists. Okay. Next is the fossil remains. What is the fossils? Fossils are the remains of plants or animals of human body and parts from the past. You have to look at this picture also. And body parts of the past preserved in rocks, and these have been buried for millions of years, and the imprints of the hard body parts such as the bones or skulls and have a permanent mark on the rocks. And fossils are the main source of the information for many species of plants and animals that have become the extinct, for example dinosaurs. Okay. Now, if you have any query, you can ask here right now. Thank you.